The seven simple steps for biodigester construction. If you are going to construct a biodigester, look out for these simple seven steps. Whether you are a beginner or you are an expert in this field, look out for these simple construction steps and your biodigester will be perfect for your client. And even if you are doing it for yourself, yeah, you'll be good to go. Now, there's also a bonus point. So I entreat you to stay to the end for this particular bonus point. So let's dive into the video. This is Dreamhouse Biodigesters. If you're new to the channel, subscribe and be part of this growing community of biodigester lovers right here in Ghana, West Africa, and of course in Africa. We are trying to be sustainable as much as we can by using simple on-site biodegradable waste biodigester for human waste treatment. So the first simple step that you need to know and decide is the selection of the location for the biodigester. What this means is that you go and do an assessment in the first place, and then you get your location right, you get the exact place you are going to site the biodigester. You can do this together with the plumber and the homeowner as well, or you can give them your technical advice. That's what is going to work for the biodigester. What it also means is that, where are the pipes coming from? How many toilets are in the house? How many pipes are coming from which part of the building? You need to know all these things to decide where you are going to place the biodigester. Some homeowners will let you know that they prefer the biodigester at the back and it's hidden. But maybe there's a guest toilet in front of the house. Is it going to work when you leave it at the back there? Will it come? Will it not fall under it? Will it be enough gradient for you to come for you? A gentle slope that will work for your biodigester. You need to agree on these ones before you decide where you are going to site the biodigester. So that's very key for you. The second simple step is that you are going to have to mark the ground and then dig the ground based on the size of the biodigester. You will have to obviously do a digging. And the difference between this type of digging and the septic system is that you are not going to go deep. Maximum feet is 2 feet. If you have to go, then probably you are looking at 3 feet. How many courses of block are you going to lay? If you are using the prefabricated slabs, are you going to put them on the block so that it can be elevated? What's the level of the house when the final groundworks are done? How many inches does the homeowner or the architect or the groundworks do they look out for? Do they want the digester to show only 2 inches? Are they looking at it flashing with the ground, or they are going to do some toweling around them? So they prefer it to show and then it becomes part of the design of the house. You will need to know all these things so that when you do your digester, you get a place for the top slab as well, and then it can be hidden, or depending on what you are looking for, you can get it nicely. I also have to get the size of the digester right. Is it a standard size family biodigester? Is it a large one? What is the purpose for which you are constructing the biodigester? Is it going to be for a commercial use? Is it going to be for a simple apartment? Or is it going to be for domestic? I mean, depending on the type of building that you have there. You have to decide on that one as well. I have the video that explains the sizes of biodigester that you can consider when you're constructing a biodigester. The link will be up in the cards and you can have a look at it to decide the type of biodigester you will need to construct. The third most important step that you need to know is the digging of the ground. What's the size of the biodigester has been determined by the marking. The third step is to dig the biodigester. I usually prefer them in a rectangular shape. The rectangular shape means that the digester has got about 6 feet on the length, and then the width is 2.5 or 3 feet, and then the depth, you're looking at 2 feet or 2.5 feet, so that you know your bedding materials are coming in, you know your filtration materials are all going to be in it, and then it's going to work as you envisage it to work for you. The reason why we also consider the rectangular shape is because the type of simple on-site biodegradable waste biodigester that we do, they work in such a way that you have an outlet leading to the soak-hole pit or the soak-away or into a drainage system, depending on whatever one is available to you for the wastewater. And you are going to do a screening at the base just to separate the water from the human waste. So the rectangular shapes work well. I've seen biodigesters that have been done in a circular shape, and then some have been done four square. We usually prefer them in a rectangular shape. The fourth step in your construction of a simple on-site biodigester is to construct a soak hole pit. Now, you have options. You do have a soak away, which means that you are going to do some block work and have the leche pipe connected to it. or you are going to have a so-called pit, which means that you are going to have stones that will be laid in it, and then you are going to have some rubber or carpet on top of it, and then you are going to put back the topsoil on it so that it can be buried in the ground. There are conditions for having a so-called pit, which means that the ground is good for you and it's going to work perfectly for soaking the wastewater that will be coming to the soak away from the biodigester. Your gradient is key in this situation. You don't want the water to go back. I've done a so-called pit, which is what I recommend you consider when you're constructing a so-called pit for a biodigester. It's simple. At the end of the shape, put a vent cap there so that no debris from the or no small stones from the so-called pit will go back and block the wastewater from coming into the so-called pit. The fifth most important step that you need to take when you are constructing a biodigester is to lay the blocks. That's if you are doing it using blocks or bricks, or to use a prefabricated slabs and have them erected to fit the size of the hole that you have dug. When you are doing biodigester using blocks, we prefer you use the quarry dust blocks because they are firm, they have been pressed, and they can contain any moist or any water that might retain in the biodigester. So you lay your blocks. If you cannot do them yourself, get an expert in terms of a mason to have the blocks laid for you, because it actually does require some technical understanding. But it's also your best bet, knowing that you are a beginner in the biodigester construction. The simple one to do is to just lay the blocks. If you also have access to a prefabricated slab, or you know how to cast these prefabricated slabs, you're also good to go. The advantage is that it means that your digester can be done within a short period of time. So you lay your blocks to match the size of the hole that you have dug, and then you lay them to the level in which you want them to be, considering where you are going to put your slabs, that's the filtration slabs, and the materials, including all the bedding materials that will go on that slab, where they are going to be, and what level room is going to be left for your inlet pipe that's coming. That's key. Remember the inlet pipe that's coming. The inlet pipe is coming from the house, and then the outlet is where the leche pipe will be leading to your so-called pit or your soak away. It's key you get this one right, because if you do not get this one right, the biodigester will be rendered ineffective, and only after using it for a few weeks or months you are going to have problems, because there's not going to be any biodegradation that will take place. Laying the blocks and getting it right is key for your biodigester construction. The sixth simple step that you have to take in constructing a biodigester is to prepare the biodigester bed, including the bedding materials. So when you are going to cast the top slabs for your biodigester, you have to cast a slab for the bedding material. This slab means that you are going to perforate them and you are going to leave holes in them. Mostly, if you are using the prefabricated slabs, we do have the chippings that have been done into porous. That's what we use for the filtration of the bedding material. You are going to have to lay them on the biodigester, because you have done your screeding when you lay the blocks, and then you have done a gradient that leads straight into the so-called pit, which means that any water that comes into the biodigester is going to be drained immediately. There is rapid separation. That's what we say, rapid separation. And that's the key difference between a biodigester and a septic system. While the septic system is a holding tank, which means that the water together with the human waste is all retained in the tank, hopefully for longer use, and then the truck will come and dislodge it. The biodegradable waste biodigesters work in such a way that the human waste is what is retained in the digester, and the wastewater is drained out immediately you flush it. And the microorganisms that you do introduce, including your bedding materials, will help biodegrade the human waste. So that in the near future, if you have to do maintenance and have them taken out, it is easy to dispose them either at your backyard garden, or it can be taken away and dumped anywhere easily at your backyard. There's no problem with that. That is exactly what you cannot get when you do a septic system, because it means that the truck will show up in the house, have to have it sipped out. It has to be taken to a treatment plant for it to be treated so that later it can be disposed of easily. In terms of the biodigester bed preparation, you will need your fiber nets, you need your coconut fiber, you need your filtration material, anything that you're using that makes it work for you. I have done a video that explains how to construct a biodigester vividly, and then it's going to be available in the description box below, and you can have a look at it after watching this video. The seventh simple step that you need to take in constructing a biodigester is to put the top slab and seal it airtight. Now, to the bonus point, somebody will tell you when you put the top slab on it, you have to give it a vent pipe. I do not subscribe to that. I've done a lot of videos explaining this one as well. I do not agree with that statement. The biodigester needs to be sealed airtight because you want it to work in the absence of oxygen, which means that any vent that comes in is going to invite unnecessary things into the biodigester. It's going to invite flies. When it rains, rain might seep in because you have put a vent pipe on it. Water might just go into the digester. And that's what the digester does not like. Digesters do not like water in them. So the vent that's needed in the house is enough to serve everybody. If you are building a house, you need to have a vent pipe as part of the construction. If a plumber shows up in the house, ask them. The first question is, do we have a vent in this house? If they don't have, tell them to create one on the wall and extend it all the way to the top so that if there's any air that needs to go out, it can pass through it. If there's air in your biodigester that needs to go out, it can come back and pass through that vent. If there's a bad smell that's also in the toilet that needs to go out, it can come through the vent and then it will go. You don't need a vent pipe on a biodigester. Aesthetically, it's not pleasing. It doesn't look nice on the eye. Locating a biodigester by the corner and putting a vent pipe on it. How long can you extend it? You are not supposed to put the vent pipe that's short on the biodigester. Huh? It's technically wrong. So use the vent that's provided in the house. Dream House Biodigester. It's a channel that we have dedicated to the construction of biodigesters. And for those who are interested in learning how biodigesters work, and for homeowners who want to use this as an option in managing their human waste in their house. The next video showing on this channel is going to explain to you in further steps how to construct a biodigester perfectly.